So if we want to turn this Riemann sum into an integral, all we have to do is slap this limit on the front of it. So let's say we've already got a Riemann sum, and we want to convert it into a definite integral. How are we going to do that? Well, this is the definition of a Riemann sum, which is a tool that we use to estimate the area under a curve. It tells you that you're trying to find the area under this function using rectangles that are each delta x wide. You're starting with the first rectangle, adding up the area of all the rectangles, and then stopping when you get to the nth rectangle. So to use a Riemann sum to estimate area, all we need is the interval AB that's going to bound the area, and the number of rectangles n that we're going to use. If we have just those two things, we can use the Riemann sum to estimate the area, and we wouldn't even have to bother with integrals at all. But remember, Riemann sums only estimate area. They don't find exact area. So if we want exact area, we have no choice but to convert the Riemann sum into a definite integral. And actually, integrals are exactly the same as Riemann sums, except that with integrals, we use an infinite number of rectangles to find the area, compared to using only a finite number of rectangles with Riemann sums. So if we want to turn this Riemann sum into an integral, all we have to do is slap this limit on the front of it, which says that we're using an infinite number of rectangles n, because we're taking the limit as n goes to infinity. And now this Riemann sum has actually become an integral already, it's just written differently. To write it as an integral, the limit and summation notation become the integral, the function f of x sub I becomes the function f of x, and the delta x becomes dx. And these two things are exactly equal. So let's put this into practice and pretend for a second that we've been given this Riemann sum. If we're asked to express this Riemann sum as a definite integral on the interval 1 to 5, then we just add this infinite limit out in front of the Riemann sum, and then we can set it equal to the integral from 1 to 5 of the same function multiplied by the dx. And just like that, we've converted the Riemann sum into a definite integral. This part, if we know the number of rectangles n and the interval AB, is the Riemann sum we use to find an approximation of the area. And this part, if we know the interval AB, is the integral we use to find the exact area.